Hi, my name is Jim Brower-Smith, and today I'd like to take you through the new capabilities in Creo Schematics 1.0. Now, for the new users, what we have is this Get Started tab. Now, this tab is fantastic. It allows you to create a sample catalog, allows you to give access to the guides within Creo Schematics, a tutorial to help you through the just learning the picks within Creo Schematics, and also log calls with tech support, and perhaps access the online library so you can download your own symbols. For the more advanced users, I'm going to do is open up a existing design, and you'll see the last time I had this design open was all these design sheets, and you'll see they open up automatically. And you'll also notice that we have these new tabs along the bottom. As I drag my cursor around the screen, you'll see I've got pre-selection highlighting to help you make better selections within your schematic. If we go to the tabs down the bottom, if you want to create a new sheet, it's just like Excel. So all I've got to do is go right click and select new sheet. I can double click in that new tab and enter the name, so it is exactly just like Excel. If I'm creating objects or placing objects, you'll notice that when I instance a group, for example, and I place down my mirror switch, you'll notice that I get the preview and it's highlighted on my cursor. I've got all the tools to select this object and new capabilities to rotate the object and to drag the object into shape wherever I want to place it. We've also got new capabilities for creating custom cable decorations. So let me go back to my Catalog Explorer and select Cable Decorations. You'll notice under the Cable Decorations, I've got one which I've created myself. And all I've done is just blanked off the fibers and added a label. So let's place down a couple of connectors. And let's place down a new cable using that new custom cable decoration. You'll see as I place the cable down, my cable decoration has been placed, and you'll see that the fibers have blanked and the name has been put in as I designed within the decoration. If I select the two cables, you'll also notice these arrows down the bottom here, which allows me to have embedded parameters. If we go to the embedded parameters, you'll see that it lists the two cables I've selected. If I sweep select multiple items, you'll see that we'll break it down into component parameters, port parameters, cable and pipe parameters. So again, making it easier for the user to identify the objects they want to edit. If you want to multi-select objects, you just drag, select, and then all you do is just hit the modify and select perhaps a new layer. If you want to organize them, you just select on the headers and organize the names. And if you want to edit, you just double click and enter whatever name you like. If you want to apply data sets, then again, you just select the objects you want to apply the data sets to, select the data set, and apply. So as you can see from this very short demonstration, we've got some great new capabilities within Creo Schematics. If you'd like to see more about Creo Schematics, then please visit our product page on ptc.com.